Hi there, YouTube. Today we're going to be talking about Cummins cylinder heads, how to reseal them, install some heavy-duty valve springs, and more. That coming up next. So we're going to go ahead and break this thing down, and the plan today is to tear this whole cylinder head apart, inspect all of the valve seats, install some heavy-duty 60-pound valve springs for some high RPM application, as well as some new seals. So I'm going to go ahead and start tearing these down. You've seen in my previous videos that I've got a piece of cardboard that's labeled with the cylinder number itself. So this is 1, 2, 3, all the way down to 6. So I'm going to start with number 1, break that apart, and go from there. What I'm going to be using to tear this down is a pneumatic cylinder valve spring compressor. It's not required to have this, but you have to have some kind of valve spring compressor. Some aftermarket ones sometimes mount to the top of the rocker arm cover, and you can cam over to do those for like an in-vehicle application. We're going to use our spring compressor, take each one out individually, keep everything in order as usual as per where it goes on the cylinder head, and then we're going to inspect the seats, get everything cleaned up, and then put it back together. Valve springs removed, we can go ahead and pull the valves themselves. And when you're doing this, you want to feel for valve guide clearance. And you can see that wiggle just a little bit. You want to compare that to all of them to see if one of them is more worn than the other. The other thing you can do is you pull the valve stem back like so. There, you look at the circle around that valve to make sure that it is all even. You would actually be able to physically see if it was worn significantly. You'd be able to physically see that it wouldn't be round all the way. So, rule of thumb is you have about 3/1000ths clearance on the intake, and you can have more on the exhaust, about 5/1000ths. So just go through all every single one of these and feel and make sure that they all feel about the same. The other thing you can do is, as a comparison, you can move the valve up and down this way and compare the clearance that direction versus the clearance this direction. And the reason that is an indicator is because those rocker arms only push that valve pretty much in one direction. You want to make sure that the face itself isn't cupped. You can see that it's not cupped, and that it's even all the way around. All of that will come out when we wire wheel it. And the same holds true for the seat itself. Cylinder head came out of the parts washer. Everything is looking really good. We got all of the valves cleaned up on the wire wheel, as you saw. And now, we're going to talk a little bit about the next couple steps here. So the valves themselves look really, really nice. They cleaned up really well. Everything looks really good. It still amazes me how little wear any of these internal parts really have. You can see a little bit on the top of the valve stem right there, but nothing significant. And with 200,000 miles, you would expect some of that. So now what we're going to do is we're going to talk a little bit about the valve seats. And these two right there, I have already gone and honed them, lapped them in. And I'm going to show you the process on how to do that on these and what you're looking for. So to do that, you guys are going to need some valve grinding compound, as well as the suction cup tool. Sell these pretty much at any auto parts place. And now my disclaimer is that this is not, I repeat, is not a substitute for a legitimate new valve job. But in our case, our cylinder head just needs to be cleaned up and verified all of the condition so that everything looked good. So what I'm going to do is get the camera set up, and then I'm going to talk to you guys, show you how this process works. So we're working on cylinder number two right here, and I'm going to grab the first intake valve right there, and what we're going to do is just put a little bit of lapping compound all along that edge, that valve face. Okay, then we're going to set it into our head, put our suction cup on like that, and then the goal here is not to push on the valve itself. Let the compound kind of do the work, and we're just going to move kind of quickly. And when you do this at home, what you'll do is you'll actually feel the compound cut, and then it'll smooth out. And that at that point, you need to put on some new compound and inspect to see what you've got. So here's how you do this. You just run it back and forth like you're starting a fire, and you'll feel the actual seat itself start to hone in. Okay, so now we will take the valve out. So what you're looking for on this inspection is you're looking to see that the hone marks, that dull spot, is consistent even all the way around. And it looks pretty darn good. So then you also want to see that same corresponding hone mark on your valve seat all the way around. Make sure you get all of your grit off there. And you can really inspect the hone marks all the way around. And again, you're looking to see that it's all even, 100% all the way around. And it'll turn it dull, and the spots that aren't actually honing or aren't touching will still continue to be shiny. So if you have significant shiny marks, then you're definitely going to have to stop and send this out to a professional machine shop and have the head machined. So now that we've finished lapping everything, it's time to get lubricant all on the valve stem and into our valve guides. We've cleaned up all of the lapping compound, and we've also cleaned the surface of this cylinder head. So we're going to go ahead and get these valves lubricated, and then stand it up and start to assemble the springs, seals, and retainers. So we are ready to go ahead and install our valve springs, but I just wanted to quickly show you the difference between the 60-pound heavy-duty springs and the stock one. The stock one's right there on the left, and it's a lot taller. so now, next step is we have our seals, we have our springs, and we have our valves installed and lubricated. So we're now going to install our valve spring seals. And in the gasket kit, they include this little cover that goes over, and that will help to protect the seal when we slide it on. So I'm going to get everything lubed up for that seal and show you guys how to press that seal on. So we have our little cover, which goes right over the end of the valve, and that is there to protect the seal when you slide it over. So to get it to slide on, I just use a little bit of assembly lube on the valve seal itself like that, and just very gently push it down over the end of that valve like so. And then while holding the valve in place on the backside with one hand, I just take a socket that fits nicely over, and I just press that seal all the way down until it seats and is even all the way around. And that's all there is to it. So now we'll do the next one. Okay, moving right on to our springs. I'm going to go ahead and just in the sequence, go ahead and install our new springs. Now, it's a good idea if you have your cylinder head, if you actually have the valves machined or the seats machined, it's a really good idea to verify and double check the installed height of the new valve. But because we are just replacing these valves, we're not going to be changing the installed height at all, and the valve is in the exact same position, we're just going to go ahead and put them in. So we're all done. We got all of our valves installed. You want to double check all of your retainers. Make sure that all looks really good. Make sure that no valve or no retainer or spring is sticking up higher than the others. And then we'll go ahead and get ready to install this on the engine block. Thanks for watching. Please subscribe to the channel and post your comments.